Then we see some techniques of the calculus of variations, which is a variation technique. Here we consider a function f of y, y dot, x. That is, f is a function of y, y dot, and x, where y dot means derivative dy by dx, depend on a path y equal y of x between the two values x1 and x2. To find the particular path y of x such that the line integral j of the function between x1 and x2, that is, j is the integral of the function f of y, y dot x dx, integration from x1 to x2, has stationary value relative to path differing infinitesimally from the function y of x. I consider the varied path for which the condition y of x1 equal to y1 and y of x2 equal to y2. The points A and B are joined by various paths. Consider this frame xy, these two points A and B, A x1 y1 and B x2 y2. These two points are joined by various paths. Suppose this path is lower path, this upper path is shown in the figure. We select any function the top x that vanishes at x equal to x1 and x equal to x2. Then this y of x alpha, it is given by y of x0 plus alpha times net of x, where net of x1 and net of x2 equal to 0. That is, the value of this neta vanishes at the points x1 and x2. For any such parameter family of curves, z in equation 1 is also a function of alpha. Therefore, we can write equation 1 is a function of alpha. That is, we can write z equal to integration from x1 to x2, function of, here we write y is a function of x alpha, y of x alpha, y dot of x alpha, and x is as it is constant, dx. That is, the integration reduces to function of alpha. Therefore, this equation 1 reduced to which is the function of alpha, j of alpha equal to integration from x1 to x2, function of, this y is a function of x alpha, y dash is a function of x alpha, and this x as it is, this equation. This way, right, in this form, j of alpha equal to integration from x1 to x2, function of y of x alpha, y dash of x alpha, x dx, which is equation 4. Now, the condition for obtaining stationary point is, and the condition for obtaining stationary point is differentiation of this dj by d alpha, dj by d alpha at alpha equal to 0 equal to 0. That is, derivative of this j with respect to alpha at alpha equal to 0 equal to 0. This is the condition to obtain the stationary point. Now, dj by d alpha means the derivative of this j. Therefore, we differentiate this equation 4 with respect to alpha under the integration sign. That is, according to Leibniz rule of integration, differentiation, under the integration sign. therefore differentiating equation 4 with respect to alpha under the integration sign according to Leibniz theorem, Leibniz rule. Therefore, derivative of left hand side dj by d alpha equal to derivative of right hand side under the integration sign, integration from x1 to x2, then derivative of this f, this is function of y alpha, x alpha, this is x alpha and this is part. The third one does not contain alpha, first contain alpha, second contain alpha, third does not contain alpha, therefore derivative of the third variable is 0. We have to differentiate only first term, second term according to chain rule. Therefore, the first del f by del y into del y by del alpha plus for the second y dot, we have del f by del y dot into del y dot by del alpha. Then derivative of third is 0, therefore we have this like this. Therefore we separate the two integrals, integration from x1 to x2, del f by del y into del y by del alpha dx plus integration from x1 to x2, del f by del y dot into del y dot by del alpha dx. So I consider the second, we integrate the second by using the integration by parts. Consider the second integral. Consider the second integral of 6, that the integration from x1 to x2 del f by del y dot into del y dot by del alpha dx. Integration from x1 to x2 del f by del y dot into del y dot by del alpha dx equal to integration from x1 to x2 del f by del y dot. Now second again, this y dot mean derivative with respect to y dot means dy by dx, therefore we can write the second one as d dx of del y by del alpha dx. Now we take this function as first and d dx of this as second function, integrating by parts, therefore first into integration of second, first function del f by del y dot. Now integration of derivative of this, integration of derivative means we get the original function del y by del alpha and limits from x1 to x2 minus integration of second means integration of derivative, we have the original function del y by del alpha into d dx of first. First means del f by del y dot dx. Now at the end point we know that del y by del alpha at x1 and x2 is 0, therefore the first term vanishes. This will get 0 because the value of del y by del alpha at the point x1 and x2 is 0. Therefore, this is 0. At upper limit, at lower limit, we have value of this as 0 because del y by del alpha at x1 and x2 is 0 at the end points. Minus the second term, integration x1 to x2, del y by del alpha into ddx of del f by del y dot dx. Since at end points a and b, del y by del alpha at x1 equal to del y by del alpha at x2 both are 0. Therefore, the first term is vanishes for upper integral and for upper limit and lower limit. Therefore, the value of the integral we get, the value of this second integral becomes this minus. Therefore, equation 6 implies dj by dl alpha equal to, when I put the value of this second integral here, that is the value is minus integration from x1 to x2 del y by del alpha into ddx of del f by del y dot into dx. From this we can take the common integration x1 to x2 and dx from the both the integrals.